Hey guys, Doug B here. Welcome to Preset of the Week, where I highlight either one of the factory presets or presets created by third-party creators. This week, we're going to take a look at Moke's custom presets. Let's listen to a little sample. Now, back in 2019, my old band from high school had been hired to play for the class of 1975's 45th class reunion. We had played for the 40th class reunion, and it went over great. Those people just loved us. And they said they didn't even think of any other bands for the 45th. It was either Pyramid or no band at all. That's how serious they were about it. Now, the reunion was going to be in July 2020, and I had gotten my Axe FX3 in December 2019. So I started putting together presets for the set list, and I also started looking at commercial preset makers to fill in some of the gaps on some of the songs in the set list. That's when I found Moke's custom presets. Now, he had just about everything that I was looking for. So I went to work on those guitar parts in January and February of 2020. And then, of course, in March of 2020, the world changed. That reunion got canceled. So it goes. But you know, knowing those people, I'll bet they'll be contacting me wanting to know if we can play the 50th class reunion in 3 years. Moke makes presets for the Axe FX3, the FM3, the FM9, the Axe 8, the Axe FX2, and various Helix units. I bought 8 of Moke's presets, 4 at a time. You get a 35% discount when you purchase 4 or more. The ones I got were Living on a Prayer version 3 for humbucker pickups, Surrender version 2 for humbucker pickups, Pour Some Sugar on Me version 2.7 for humbucker pickups, Wicked Game version 2.2 for single coil pickups, Sweet Emotion version 2 for humbucker pickups, and The Boys Are Back in Town version 2.4 for humbucker pickups. Those 6 are called artist/song-specific presets. I also bought presets from the general multi-purpose presets category. These 2 are Moke's Brit 800 version 3.1 for humbucker pickups, and Moke's Acoustic Simulator version 5.7 for humbucker pickups. You absolutely have to read the documentation that comes with each preset. Some of Moke's presets are set up for humbuckers, others for single coil. As you can see, I bought mostly for humbuckers, and each preset has versions for low, medium, and high output pickups. There's also versions for use with external controller pedals as well as with no pedals. Some of the presets require you to install cab IRs in specific user bank locations. Moke has free updates for his presets, so I downloaded the latest versions, which are for firmware 16.05. Now, we can't explore these presets block by block because they're commercial. I will list the scene names for each preset though, and I'll show you the grid so that you can see how complex some of these presets are. I shortened Moke's presets names so they're easier to read on my FC6. I also changed the names of some of the scenes and put them in the order that I thought worked best. Our band is usually a 4-piece, but our lead guitarist wasn't going to be able to do this show, so I had to cover all the guitar parts by myself. Our opening song has always been The Boys Are Back in Town, and it has harmonized guitar parts in the chorus, solo, and outro. I was able to play both parts, but it really didn't sound quite right. Moke's preset took care of that. It's pretty involved, and you even have to enter in values for 3 of the global scales in order for this preset to work. I had no idea what global scales were, and I had to ask Moke for some guidance. But it worked amazingly well once I got everything set up correctly. Now, one of the things I had to do, this preset is set up for you to play it in A, but it goes down to A flat. That's because there was a pitch block right here. The first thing was a pitch block that brought the tone down 1, I do believe it was. So if you're playing in A, it would bring it down to A flat. Our band plays it in G. It does not need to be brought down to F sharp or brought up. So I just eliminated that block. And in the pitch block here, I had to change the key from A flat to G in channel A and in channel B. Otherwise, Oh man, there were some interesting issues. Our band really wasn't planning on doing Wicked Games, but I got the preset just in case I could talk the other guys into it. I mean, I just love that cloud of delay and reverb used on the lead guitar. We also weren't planning on doing Living on a Prayer or Sweet Emotion, but we were planning to do Rocky Mountain Way, and I wanted to try out Moke's Talkbox Sims to see if one of them would work. The one on Living on a Prayer did a really good job, but I was just getting into working this one out when the gig got canceled. I got the acoustic sim preset because we were going to do Tears in Heaven, and I didn't want to have to switch guitars. I think it would have done the job, but we never got the chance to rehearse and find out. We were going to do Surrender, and if our lead guitarist was with us, he would have played guitar and I would have played keys, doing that sequence synth part. Instead, Moke's preset covers it perfectly, and yeah, it covers the synth key changes too. B flat to B, and then up to C. I didn't have a specific song for the Brit 800 preset, but I'll bet that would have worked out just fine for Ballroom Blitz. We also weren't planning on doing Pour Some Sugar on Me, but we were going to do Rock of Ages. So I figured I'd try this preset to see if it would work. So there you have it, guys. Moke's custom presets are a welcome part of my preset library, and I'm sure that I'm going to be buying some more from him. His stuff is just excellent. Why don't you try out a couple of his presets? Let me know how it goes for you. I'll put a link to his website in the description. Now this Friday, we are going to look at something that I found in AxeEdit. Maybe you knew about it already, but I didn't. And when I found it, mind was blown. Now you don't want to miss that, so go ahead and hit that subscription button and ring that notification bell. All right, guys, see you on Friday.